I'm an innovation manager at The Water Hub, which is a three-year funded project with support from the European Regional Development Fund and four strategic partners who are Northumbrian Water, Durham County Council, the Environment Agency, and Durham University. And we provide support to small businesses to innovate in the water and environment sector. To me, everyday excellence sums up the fact that water is an essential service. It's vital to our everyday needs, but there's no reason why we shouldn't have high expectations or big ambitions for how great that service can be. I think collaboration and partnership play a really key role in adding value to the water sector, particularly with input from communities relating to their local environment and the sharing of ideas and best practice across sectors. Our water resources face a huge amount of challenges in the coming years, both on the water side and the wastewater side. I think the changes in rainfall that we're going to see with climate change and the impact that that will have on flooding and drought will be a tremendous problem. Also, the amount of energy that we use and how we can optimize that in both water and wastewater treatment processes. But also dealing with all the data that we get from these systems and how we can better understand and optimize our processes by understanding this data better. I think those are really key challenges in the sector, but I also think they provide countless possibilities for innovation. The big societal challenges we're trying to address, whether that's resilience to climate change or a more holistic approach to catchment management, they've got lots of underlying drivers and also lots of different stakeholders involved. So, the Water Hub has a really diverse and growing network, and we bring together small innovative businesses with local communities, end users, government organisations, research institutes, and lots of other different players who work together in partnership. And by doing so, we help them to co-develop solutions so that we can enable the sharing of ideas and resources across organizational boundaries. Essentially, this just means that there's more knowledge and resource available to tackle the problem in the first place, but there's also the buy-in across the sector for those solutions once they're developed too. So the Water Hub has supported some fantastic innovations. We've awarded a number of small grants to support businesses to develop ideas and prototypes to test new things in real-world situations. And these have ranged from citizen science apps to new ways of capturing, storing, and controlling rainwater runoff from rooftops. And on top of that, we've also facilitated a number of research collaborations. We've delivered some really energetic and exciting events. But I think crucially, and one of the things that's probably most important for the businesses that we've worked with, we've helped them to land contracts, access new markets, and ultimately this helps them to grow. So my research background is in engineering, specifically looking at novel wastewater treatment processes. And so I'm always keen to speak to the businesses about an exciting new technology. But it's also important to make sure we're capturing some of the creative and societal innovation that's necessary to facilitate change. I think we need to support a better informed and more engaged community. We need stakeholders that are more invested in tackling challenges. And we need to ensure that engagement doesn't dwindle with time. So how do we ensure that these positive changes that we're making, such as things that are promoted through smart metering or monitoring devices, how are they maintained week by week, year after year? That's where integrating technology and human behaviour really plays a role. But water future is not solely decided by regulators or water companies. Every single person in the population has a role to play in supporting a more sustainable future. It's primarily about education and opportunity, engaging local communities to understand what role water has in economic prosperity and their well-being, and also telling them about the simple changes that they can make to improve the quality and the quantity of water available to them now and in the future. I think traditionally the sector has had more of a focus on engineered systems such as treatment works, pipes networks, more of a focus on built-up urban areas. particularly when addressing challenges like climate change resilience and water quality from micropollutants, it will become increasingly important to view the river catchment and all of its component parts more holistically. The interaction of all of the different stakeholders, from government organisations to farmers, rural populations, water companies, it's extremely important to balance their needs and interests with what's best for the environment, the economy and our own well-being. So we work in a sector which is really data rich, but I think there's two key challenges within that. I think the first is access to that data and knowing what to do with it once you have accessed it. So the northeast of England has an absolutely stellar digital sector, and the Water Hub has built some fantastic relationships within this. One of the first events we ran was a hackathon in partnership with the Environment Agency to look at how they could make the data that they have more digestible to the stakeholders that use it. And this might include charities or landowners, but so that they could use that data and it would inspire local action. So we were able to support one of the winners of the hack to develop a simple to navigate platform so that the users aren't overwhelmed with the volume of data that they're presented with. And I think collaborations like this are really necessary to provide that specialist insight from people who really know how to process data. But unfortunately, it's not that common because there is still a barrier of access to data. Innovation to me is very simply about translating an idea into something tangible, and that can be a product, a process, or a service. It's at its very simplest, something that can deliver an improvement on how things are currently done. I think one of the main barriers to innovation in the sector is procurement. So we work with so many businesses that have got brilliant ideas, but they often struggle to get those ideas, whether it's a product or a service, seen and heard by the right people. I think small businesses in particular in our sector really struggle with moving on from that trial stage. Unfortunately, there's no standard or one-size-fits-all approach. So quite often a brilliant idea that might be tested with one utility will have to be tested and trialed again with several others. And this not only slows the rate of adoption of innovation, it also puts a huge burden on the small business who are actually quite often having to foot the cost of that trial. So rather than being able to sell their at-market product as part of business as usual, they're repeating the trial process with multiple utilities. So we've already discussed the huge challenges we're facing in the water sector, and as such, it's inevitable that there's going to have to be some transformation in public policy and regulation to address and meet those challenges. But I think tightening consents and needing to do more with less actually provides an excellent platform for innovation. So going back to the definition I gave earlier, innovation is about improving the way things are currently done. So fundamentally, that's the role I see the regulator playing in response to securing affordable, clean and plentiful supply in an ever-changing climate. So I've been so inspired by the number of businesses I've met through working at the Water Hub who create, deconstruct and innovate around problems to provide solutions to the challenges that we face in the water sector. I think the one thing that would make the biggest difference to innovation in the water sector doesn't lie with how creative we can be, but how prepared we are to take a risk. I think that the sector needs to be a little bit faster in adopting innovations. And to do that, they have to be prepared to try something that might fail and learn from it. I like the three shifts made in Ofwat's emerging strategy, looking at how we create a better future and put a spotlight on the wider public benefits that companies can deliver. But I think the inclusion of the importance of transformational change, which focuses on enabling the adoption of innovation, improving relationships between stakeholders and drawing insight from data, is really the kind of most fantastic part of it. I think it really aligns quite closely with what the Water Hub is seeking to achieve. I think education has the potential to have the most profound impact on creating a better future for water and the environment. And I don't just mean school age education. We need to improve our understanding of water use and consumption, need to encourage creativity and problem solving and promote collaborative partnership working across generations for a better water future.